Well, these are such strange times. It seems like things are shifting so much day to day. But I'm so grateful for this practice, for this time that we can gather together, and whether it's literally or virtually, to take some time to breathe and to be in the body and to practice being here, to practice being present. So go ahead and find your seat, everybody, and let's take the first few moments here in stillness. Notice your breath. This fullness and presence and quality of your breath this morning. Noticing how the body makes space, makes room for your inhale, your in-breath. And releasing completely the out-breath. You can even notice the pause between the inhale and the exhale when you're all the way full. And that pause at the bottom of the exhale before you draw your next breath in. And in this way, using the breath as an anchor to our present moment experience. And so if you are familiar with Ujjayi breath, that victorious breath, you can begin that now. So gently engaging the muscles of the back of your throat to draw the breath in and out of the body, still through the nostrils, but perhaps allowing the breath to slow down just a little bit. You'll hear a gentle whisper sound as you breathe in this way. And with the hands resting gently on your knees or on your thighs, let's start to move the upper body just a little bit, side to side. And start to move your spine, torso. And then you can start to move your upper body in more of a circle or a figure eight. Moving in any way that feels nurturing and mobilizing to your body this morning. Let's take two or three more breaths here. And then come back to your upright position. Stretch your right arm up alongside your ear. Reach up tall, and then come up and over into a side bend, side stretch. Lengthening along the right arm and ribs and side body. Good. Continue to tune into your breath moment to moment. And take one more breath here. And then as you exhale, you're going to turn the chest toward the floor, toward this left side, and bring the right hand down either to the ground or to the opposite. And then send your right arm back up, reach up tall, and release right hand to the floor. You guys strikes. Take your left arm and stretch it up. Reach up tall, lengthen, and come up and over into your side bend, your side stretch. Lengthening along the left arm and ribs and side body. Good. Take one more spacious breath here. And then go ahead and turn chest toward the floor. Bring your left hand down to the ground or to opposite knee. And take a couple breaths here, really targeting the left side of your low back. Nice, you guys. And then go ahead and bring that left arm back up, stretch up, lengthen, and bring the hand to the floor. Good. Bring your hands behind you, uncross your legs, plant your feet to the floor, the feet just a little bit wider than your hips. Puff up through your heart, through your chest. And then let's go ahead and windshield wiper the knees side to side. If this doesn't feel good to your wrists or your shoulders, you could drop down to your forearms or even onto your back. But just bringing a little bit of movement and mobilization into your hips and your low back. Good. Last round here. And bring the knees back up. Go ahead and shift forward now to the hands and the knees. And as you come forward, set this up, coming into this tabletop position. And move a little bit here through cat to cow. So inhale into a gentle back bend, opening the heart. Exhale to round the spine. Lift chin to chest. And go back and forth here a few more rounds. Good. And then on your next exhale, go ahead and sit all the way into child's pose for a few breaths, just letting your forehead rest on the ground, on the earth. You're welcome to take your knees a little bit wider if that feels better to your knees or your hips. But just take a few moments here feeling the ground, feeling the earth. And can you let the body relax just a little bit more to the ground for your last breath here? Maybe send a sigh out your mouth and relax your jaw. Good. You guys come back up, hands and knees. Tuck your toes under. Press your way up to your downward facing dog, lifting through the hips. This first down dog of your practice, move around a lot. Bend and straighten the legs. Shift your hips side to side. Press one heel to the floor and then the other. You're welcome to take your feet wider to about the edges of your mat. Sometimes that's my favorite in my first down dog, just to take a really wide base. And just feel into the floor, into the ground with your hands and your feet firmly. Again, noticing the quality, the presence of your breath. And balancing here, sukha and sthira. So these qualities of ease and effort in your asana, in your posture, your yoga pose. Take one more breath here in your downward facing dog. You can bring your feet back closer together if you'd like. Bend your knees deeply, look forward toward the top of your mat. Step or hop forward. Lengthen your spine on your in-breath, so come to that halfway lift. And then exhale, fold. Hang out here for a few breaths. Relax your neck, your jaw. Keep your knees fairly bent. We're gonna walk toward the left side. The shoulder, feel into that right side body. Good. And then let's take it over to the other side. So walk your hands over toward the right side of your mat, maybe toward the right corner. And same thing here, you're gonna pull that left hip back away from the shoulder. Feel into that side body. Walk your fingertips back to center. Anchor your feet, feel your feet on the ground. Let's come up to standing. You can roll up or do that reverse swan dive. That's up to you. As you come up, stretch the arms up, reach up, gaze up, and then exhale, hands together, heart center. Take the arms back up on in-breath, stretch up, lift and lengthen. Exhale, dive forward and fold. Hands down toward the floor, let your head relax. Flat back as you inhale, so lengthen chest and belly away from the thighs. Exhale, fold back in. Let's come back up to standing on in-breath. So ground your feet, stretch up, reach up, open. And then hands together in front of the heart. Moving with your breath, stretch up tall as you inhale, lengthen and reach. Exhale, dive forward and fold. Hands down toward the floor, relax your neck. Flat back as you inhale, extend. Plant your hands to the floor. Set up for plank pose. So step the feet back, shoulders over wrists and elbows. Strong legs fired up at your core. You can always modify this by coming down to your knees. Let's take a couple more breaths here. Think about hugging everything in toward the belly and toward that midline. Now you can go to down dog from here or lower down slowly, chaturanga, dandasana. Slide your forearms forward for sphinx pose. So the elbows shift forward kind of underneath your shoulders or a little bit beyond your shoulders. Pull your rib cage and your heart forward. Feel for traction in your low back. Telescope the rib cage and the chest forward for one more breath. And then bring it back to the floor. Slide your hands back. Now you can come up to hands and knees or fire up the legs, press up to plank pose, and then make your way back to downward facing dog. A little lift through the tailbone here and through the waistline. Think about navel lifting up and back toward the spine. Maybe the heels of the feet will settle a little closer to the floor. Take one more breath here. Bend your knees, look forward, step or hop, top of the mat. Lengthen your spine as you inhale, halfway lift, stand. Exhale, fold, and bring it in. Anchor the feet, let's come all the way up to standing. So root down, stretch up tall, reach up and lengthen. And then hands come together in front of the heart. Take the arms back up on in-breath, stretch up, and reach tall. This time, as you exhale, bend your knees and sit into a chair pose. So for the first couple of breaths, you guys, keep your arms extending alongside your ears. Keep your fingers spread wide, hands active. Sit a little bit deeper. Think about pulling the thighs back and the feet rooting down. Bend your elbows and take a goal post position with the arms. So you slide your shoulders away from the ears, try to squeeze your shoulder blades toward one another on the back, and then lift up through the chest. One more breath here in goal post. Exhale, take your hands behind you, and let's try to close clasp the hands. If that doesn't work for you, just have your arms reaching back all the same. Pull your shoulder blades toward one another, lift up through the chest. Take one more breath here. Keep your clasp if you're able, and dive forward, coming into your fold. Relax your head, neck, your jaw. Knees can be bent. Give this one more breath here. Good, nice breathing, you guys. Release your clasp and bring your hands toward the floor. Lengthen out the spine, halfway lift. And then take hands down. You can step or hop your way back. Chaturanga, optional here. You're moving through it. Lower down on your exhale. Open up to cobra or sphinx or up dog, your version of this heart opener. And then exhale, downward facing dog. Pause here for a moment. Feel into the ground firmly with both hands. And then extend your right leg back behind you. Reach it up. Take an extra breath here. Active through the foot. Good. And then as you exhale, hug your right knee in toward the chest. Pause here for a moment. Really lift through your core. And without momentum, step your right foot through into a lunge. Come down to your back knee for this first lunge. Bring your hands up to your right thigh. Squaring off the hips, imagine you're steering this big steering wheel to the right just a little bit. Strong core, extend and lengthen up through the arms. If this bugs your left knee, then flip over that outer edge of the mat or use it as some cushion, some padding. You can deepen into the lunge a little bit, keeping your core strong. Bend your elbows. Squeeze shoulder blades toward one another on the back. Lift up through the chest, deepen into the lunge. Take one more breath here. Good, and then hands down to the floor. Pick up your back knee, and you're going to shift the weight forward onto the right foot, the front foot, for standing splits. Left leg goes up into the air. Fingertips can stay on the floor, or you can start to hug and fold over your right leg. Maybe the right hand and forearm behind your calf. Breathe here, you guys. Fire up your top leg. So as you root through your right foot, extend your left leg up a little higher. Take another breath here. Good. And then hands down to the floor. If they're not already, step that left foot to the very back of your mat. Center the right knee over your ankle. And take the right arm up for a twisting lunge. Left knee can round. Okay, so left knee can come down. Or if you happen to have a block is handy underneath your left hand. So really push into the floor with that right foot. Hug the right hip back a little bit away from the knee. And lift the chest up. So you're trying to turn the heart toward the sky. Take another cleansing breath here. Open it wide, lean back. Right hand to the floor. Right foot steps to plank. Pause here. Shift your weight into your right hand. Roll to the pinky toe side of your right foot for Vashistasana side plank. Lots of ways to modify this. You can come down to the right knee or the right forearm. Pull your hips up, you guys, away from the floor. Strong and lifted at your belly. Send your left arm forward. Reach the fingertips toward the front of the room. Maybe float your left leg. Good, you guys. Last breath here. All the way back to plank pose. Pause here. You choose directly to down dog or chaturanga. Moving through that vinyasa. And then making your way to downward facing dog. Whew. Good job. Take take a breath and send your left leg in the air. Take your time, be patient, slow and steady. Each breath counts. Take one more here, reach and lengthen through the left leg, the left toes. Now as you exhale, pull your left knee in toward your chest. Lift the belly, round your spine. Hold here for a breath, really lift through your core. Without momentum, step your foot through. Come down to your back knee. And bring your hands up to your thigh. Now again, you can flip over the right side of your mat or pad the knee. Steer that big steering wheel a little bit to the left, strong core. And then arms reach up. Grow tall in this pose. And then we'll goalpost the arms, bending the elbows. Squeeze toward that midline. You can deepen into your lunge a little bit. Turn your heart more open. Couple more breaths here. Good. Extend back up. Bring your hands to the floor. We're going to pick up the back knee and step forward. So shift the weight toward your left leg, float the right leg up. Fingertips can stay on the floor or blocks, or maybe you bow to the leg, left hand and forearm behind your left calf. Lengthen and reach through those right toes, strong through your core. As you root down through that left foot, through that standing leg, lengthen your right leg up a little higher. Give this one more breath, you guys. Step it back to your lunge. So center left knee over the ankle, right hand to the ground or block, and sweep your left arm up. So again, here that back knee can come down for a little more support. Good. Take another breath here. Root down through that left foot. Pull your left hip back a little bit away from the knee and open your heart. Last full breath. Exhale, left hand back to the floor. Step your way back to plank. Pause here. Stay strong through your legs and through your core. Shift your weight into your left hand. Roll to the pinky toe side of your left foot. Send your right arm up. Side plank, Vashistasana. You can come down to the knee or the forearm. Pull hips away from the floor. Send your right arm forward alongside your ear. Reach through the fingertips. Maybe float that right leg up. Good, you guys, last breath. Stay strong. Make your way back to plank pose. Again, your choice, down dog or slowly through your chaturanga. Cobra or up dog, downward facing dog. Whew. Nice job, you guys. Take a full breath in, sending a sigh out your mouth. Come down to your knees for dolphin pose. Not child's pose. Do not do it. No child's pose, whether you're here or online. Okay, forearms down. Look at David. Ooh, I've just called him out. Sorry. He's already in dolphin. He's an overachiever. Okay. So forearms parallel. Tuck your toes under. Do you guys want the dolphin song?
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know how to do that with the live stream. I gotta figure that out.
We could sing it.
The sky looks pissed. If you're online, I'm really sorry. I don't know what's happening.
We've lost control.
Good. So breathe here, you guys. Make sure your elbows aren't creeping out and a little bit wide.
wider than your shoulders. Keep it all contained and reined in. Maybe tiptoe forward a little bit towards your face. Keep your jaw and your neck relaxed and space between the shoulders and the ears. Now, send your right leg up into the air. Reach it up as tall as you can. If you want to do a little hop or two toward Pincha Mayurasana, you can do that. And then switch legs. So right foot goes down. Left leg in the air. Reach, reach, reach. Good. And then maybe a couple hops toward your forearm balance. Good. Bring it back to regular dolphin. Take your feet out wide like we did at the beginning in down dog. Three more breaths here. You can do it. Send your last sigh out your mouth. Let it go. Come on down to your knees. Child's pose. I don't think that was quite 3 minutes, but it was close. Here in child's pose, walk your hands over to the left of your mat. So you're coming into a little bit of a side body stretch here. It can be any amount, any degree. And if you'd prefer to just keep it center, that's fine. Good, and then let's walk the hands over to the right and stretch the left side body. Center and back up to hands and knees and then downward facing dog. I hate to ask this, you guys, but does anybody have the time? I realize I do not know what time. 9:30? Okay, halfway done. Make sure your shoulder girdle is stable and steady. Right foot through into a high lunge. Now I want you to keep your fingertips on the floor here for a moment. You can kind of tent the fingers. Keep your right knee centered over the ankle. Back heel lifted, strong and rooted through your back, ball of your back foot. Now, squeeze your inner thighs towards center line like you're squeezing a block. Now I want you to take the fingertips away from the floor. So you're floating the hands away from the floor using the stabilization of your legs. Sweep your arms back along your sides. Like you're trying to reach the fingertips toward the back of the room. And as you do that, you can put a little bend in your elbows and try to squeeze your shoulder blades toward one another so your heart is a little more open and the shoulders are back. Now, keep your legs stable, take your arms forward alongside your ears, and come all the way upright. So you're coming into this high lunge. If you need to adjust your stance a little bit, that's fine. Strong, if you can put a little bend in your back knee as you reach up tall. Take another full breath here. And then as you exhale, let's bring the hands to the right thigh. Lean forward a little bit. Pick up your back leg, coming into a warrior three balance. The hands can stay on the thigh, or the arms can go back along your sides. If they go back along your sides, continue to squeeze your shoulders back.
For a little extra challenge, take the arms forward alongside your ears for that warrior three. Take one more breath here, guys, and then step that left foot to the back of the mat. Come back upright and take your arms down. Clasp your hands behind your back. Pull your shoulders back, lift your chest, bend your back knee a lot so it hovers a couple of inches from the floor. You need to hop that back foot in a little bit in order to do that, that's fine. Knuckles down, left knee toward the floor. Squeeze those inner thighs, pull your shoulders back, lift up through your chest, maybe a little bit of a back bend. Straighten up your back leg, chest and belly toward your right thigh. Keep your clasp, pick up your back leg. Don't hate me. Just do it. Breathe. Good, good, good. I'll make it up to you in one sec. Okay, come back to your lunge. Reach your arms up. Right hand to right thigh, left hand to the ground. Now listen, we're going to come back into a lunge. So the right arm, sorry, a twisting lunge, right arm reaches up. Now, here's what I want you to do, you guys. Unweight your left hand. Keep it there, or elbow to knee, prayer twist. For three more breaths, you guys can do it. Squeeze those legs toward that center. Open up your chest. Maybe spread the arms, send a sigh out your mouth. Good, hands down. Walk your hands over to the left side. Now, listen, we're gonna bend into the left knee and straighten out the right leg for Skandasana, this crouching tiger pose. It's okay for the left toes to point out. It's okay for the left heel to lift up. Be mindful of your left knee. If you are in a position here to unweight your hands and kind of float here or come into a little bit of a twist, taking that right arm up or a bind, you can work with that. Take another breath. And then come back through center and just take the other side so you can turn the right toes out a little bit, bend into your right knee, flex your left toes back. Your choice whether you unweight your hands or come into a twist or a bind. Last breath here. Bring it back through center. Parallel your feet and come into Prasarita Uttanasana. So lengthen your spine and then fold in. Five deep breaths. Good, you guys, on your next in-breath, lengthen, root down through your feet, exhale, bring your hands to your hips, connect to your core, come all the way up to your upright position. Turn the right toes forward, setting up for triangle pose, Uttita Trikonasana. So extend the arms out, we're going to push through that back foot, reach forward like you're trying to touch the front of the room, and then maintain that length, tilt the body over. A block is really handy here if you've got one underneath that right hand. Now, I'm gonna ask you to do something a little bit different. People are throwing blocks in the back of the room, just saying. So, take your right hand, the back of your right hand, and press it to the inner right calf or ankle. So that's kind of your connection. You're not pushing on top of your shin, but kind of pressing into toward the inner right leg and extend the left arm up even more. Good, using a little bit more core strength and leg strength in triangle pose. Take two more breaths here. Gaze down at the floor, Ardha Chandrasana, half moon. So shift forward, one more standing balance here, stacking the hips. So as best you can, stack your left hip over your right, left shoulder over your right. Grow a little bit taller. Spread all four limbs here as wide as you can. Maybe bend your top leg and find your foot. Half bow. It's an option. Take another breath. Beautiful, guys. Release. Left hand down. Step back to a low lunge. So your left knee is going to come down to the floor. Bring both hands to the inside of the right foot. This might be where you stay in this low lunge, or you could bring your forearms down to the floor or a block. You could choose to pick up your back knee and lift your hips up a little bit. You can work your head towards your ankle, or you could even work into a twig pose or stick pose if you want to work with an arm balance. So, with twig pose, you would wrap the right arm and shoulder around the inside of the right leg, right hand over to the pinky toe side of the foot, hop your back foot forward a little bit, walk your hands well beyond your toes, and pick up this back leg. Good. Take another breath here wherever you are. And then hands to the floor, you're going to send your right leg back behind you, reach it up, bend your leg and open the hip, and I want you to take three huge circles with your right leg. So you can keep your leg bent and draw these circles with your knee, and then you can go the other direction if you like. Good, and then we're going to take the right leg all the way into pigeon. Right knee through. Reclined pigeon is an option if that's better for your knee. So that figure four reclined onto your back. Take a breath here. Squeeze toward that center. Lift your chest up. Walk your hands forward and fold. Really nice, you guys. Take 3 to 5 more breaths here in your pigeon. And as you come back to your upright position, shift your weight over to your right hip. This back leg, this left leg, will swing around and cross all the way up and over. And if that's a little bit much today, just stretch your right leg out in front of you. Okay? So left leg is over top your right leg. Left fingertips will be behind you. Right arm stretches up. Lengthen, and then bring elbow to knee or hand to knee as you move into this twist. So everybody's twisting toward the left side. Good. Press into the floor equally through the base of your pelvis. Six bones. Can you sit up just a little bit taller? Slight uplift of your heart and ring out the spine. Good. Take 2 more breaths here. We're just going to rewind what we did. So the left leg will go back behind us, so back to pigeon. And then the hands will come to the floor. Back toes tuck under, send the right leg up. Three-legged down dog. Bend your leg, open the hip, keep it here, or flip your dog over to a three-legged back bend. That's just an option. Wild thing pose. Or you can even come into a version of Vashistasana, side plank on the left hand. Last breath. And bring it on back to plank pose. Your choice, directly to down dog or vinyasa. Good, you guys, take a moment here in your downward facing dog. And then send your left leg up. Reach it tall. Bend your left leg, lift, and open up the hip. So notice if, as you lift your left hip up, if it anchors your right heel or foot closer to the floor. Keep your shoulder girdle steady and level. Step your left foot through into a lunge. Now, we're going to keep that back heel lifted, fingertips on the floor for a moment, square it off toward the front of the room, and let's try to unweight the hand. So using the stabilization of your legs, muscles hugging toward that center. Take the arms back along your sides. So your body is still forward, pitched forward at a diagonal. Put a little bend in your elbows, squeeze shoulder blades toward one another, lengthen through the crown of your head. And then send your arms forward alongside your ears and bring this whole thing upright to a crescent lunge. So arms reaching up, hips square. You can modify your stance a little bit if you need to. Put a bend in your back knee. Take one more breath here. Hands to left thigh. Lean forward a little bit. Press into that thigh. You're going to shift forward into warrior three. Standing leg can be bent. You can keep the hands to thigh or fingertips to the floor, or take the arms back along your sides. And for a little extra challenge, maybe extend forward, arms alongside your ears. Two more breaths here. Breathe through it, you guys. Step back to your high lunge. Arms up, and then arms come down. Clasp your hands behind your back. Pull back through your shoulders, lift your chest, bend your back knee a lot. So not quite to the floor, but almost. Strong core, squeeze thighs in, knuckles down, back knee down, shoulders back, lift chest up. Take another breath here. Straighten up back leg, chest and belly to your left thigh. Keep the fingers interlaced, pick up this back leg. Find your balance here, won't be here for too long. You can do it. Strong and stable through that standing leg, lengthening through the crown. Step back again to your high lunge. Reach arms up, I'm out of breath. Whew. Left hand to left thigh. Take the right hand down to the ground. Now you can keep the left hand on the left thigh or send it up. Now I want you to really fire up your legs, unweight your right hand so it hovers. Good. And then maybe elbow to knee, prayer twist, maybe spread the arms. Three more breaths here wherever you are. Really commit to that. Core strength here, open up the chest, bring your hands down, walk the hands to your right. Skandasana or crouching tiger. So you're going to turn your right toes out a little bit, bend your right knee, flex your left foot back. Modify as you need to. If this bucks your knee, then you can skip it or not go quite so far or sit on a block. Maybe unweight your hands. or come into a little twist or bind. Nice breathing, you guys. Let's come out of that, take the other side. So shift your weight over into your left foot, maybe the knee or the toes turn out a little bit. You can unweight your hands or twist. Center, parallel your feet, extend your spine, and then fold. So this time around, pick something different. Maybe clasp your hands behind your back and take your hands forward away from the low back. Maybe bind your toes. Or if you're familiar with headstand from this position, you can work with that. So shifting your weight toward your head, floating the feet up, and coming up into your headstand. A couple more breaths. Let's bring everything back down. Flat back as you inhale. Keep your feet grounded, hands to hips, connect to core. Come all the way up to standing. Good. Turn the left toes forward, triangle pose. So your arms will re-extend out. Push with your back foot, lengthen forward. Maintain that length, tilt the body over. So left hand toward left shin, maybe to a block, right arm reaching up. Now let's do the same thing here we did on the other side. So the outer left hand will press into the inner left leg, inner calf or ankle, as you turn the heart open. So bringing a little more engagement and stability in your legs and your core. Take two more breaths here as you reach that right arm up. Good. Ardha Chandrasana or half moon. So shift your gaze down. Let's rock the weight forward and lift. So stacking the body on its side. Imagine you're right up against a wall. Maybe keep it here, reaching through all four limbs, or come into your bind, grabbing a hold of your right foot. Notice the presence and the quality of your breath here in this pose. Take one more. Good. Release out of that. Step your right foot back. Come down to your back knee for your low lunge. Both hands to the inside of your left foot. Maybe that's your pose. Or you can drop down to your forearms, or pick up your back knee and work toward head to ankle pose. If you want to work into your arm balance, slide your left arm and shoulder wrapped around the inside of the leg. So the left hand ends up on the pinky toe side of the foot. You can hop your back toes forward, walk your hands beyond your left foot, and pick up this back leg. Two more breaths. Good. Let's unwind that wherever you are. Send your left leg back behind. Reach it up. Bend your leg and open the hip. Three large circles with your left leg. You can bend your leg and circle your knee. Good. Go the other way. And then setting up for pigeon. So left knee through. Recline onto your back if that's a better option. Square up the hips, lift up. And walk the hands forward.
oxygen, allowing the body to settle.
Your right leg, your back leg will swing around, cross up and over. Stable through your pelvis, even through your hips. You have the option of stretching the left leg forward. Okay. Right fingertips behind you, left arm reaches up as you come into this twist. Elbow to knee, or you can hold on to the leg, twisting towards your right side. Helpful for you here, close your eyes and just allow your body to be moved by your breath, making space for each in-breath, releasing completely each out-breath. Good. Can you sit up a little bit taller, lifting through the heart? Last breath, maybe sigh out your mouth. Good. Unwind out of that. Take your right leg, the one that's on top, take it back behind you, back to pigeon, just for a moment. And then unwave your front leg, your left leg. Stretch it back. Reach it up. Bend your left leg. Turn and open your hip. Now, maybe keep it here or unweight your left hand and flip your dog over. Three-legged back bend or a version of side plank. Take one more breath. Bring it back to regular plank pose, chaturanga, or directly back to downward. Good, you guys, take a breath and step or jump through to your seat. Come all the way onto your backs. Hug your knees in. Rock side to side. Up for your feet, happy baby. Sometimes it's nice here to rock this side to side, drawing your tailbone or sacrum down, stabilizing. Lengthening the low back. You take one more breath here. And then release your feet, hug your knees back in. And I'd like for you to finish up with any last sequence that would feel good to you, a spinal twist of choice, or if a bridge pose would feel really good to you here, or a supported bridge, or even taking your legs and your hips up into a shoulder stand. Got just a couple of minutes here to complete this physical part of our practice. place of surrender. One of my favorite poems by Rumi says, "Very little grows on jagged rock. Be ground. Be crumbled. So wildflowers will come up where you are. You have been stony for too many years. Try something different. Surrender." Very little grows on jagged rock. Be ground. Be crumbled. So wildflowers will come up where you are. You have been stony for too many years. Try something different. Surrender. To expand your breath here. You can move the body as you're ready. Stretching and lengthening in your own way, reawakening. Bless you. Come over to your side, fetal position. Back up to your seat. Take the arms all the way up and hands come together. The heart. Beautiful practice, everybody. We'll finish with one round of Namaste.